من ذا الذي يقرض الله قرضا حسنا فيضاعفه له وله أجر كريم
تقال العثار العظام به ويرد الهوى ككبش ذبيح بذكر الإله.
Success I enjoy, the bigger contribution I need to make to those around me, the more I have to help spread the good and spread the wealth, really. You know, the idea of becoming employers, the idea of, you know, helping develop sustainable institutions in our community. All of this embedded in the word mustakhlafina fi, things you've been left capable of, things that we've been given ability to do, and we're supposed to, you know, maximize our potential in them. فَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا مِنْكُمْ وَأَنْفَقُوا لَهُ أَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. My favorite part of the verse, and I'm done. That's the ending of the ayah. And that is, those of you who truly have faith then, and then do spend, لَهُمْ أَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. They're going to have huge compensation. Obviously, all of us invest for the purpose of return on investment. That is one of the most fundamental premises of making an investment. And God is even saying that your spiritual investment, that, you know, that disposable income that you're, you know, using to do other things with, that is actually also an investment, but the return on that investment is in your next life, and it's going to have huge returns. لَهُ أَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. So I really think this is, it really sets the tone for the spirit, Muslim entrepreneurial spirit, because it is distinct. I feel it is distinct, and it has a very driven, line of thinking behind it. And it, on the one hand, unfortunately, in some circles, you know, entrepreneurial success is, I guess, worldly success, and we're not supposed to be worldly people, and therefore it's looked down upon. And that's actually not an Islamic idea at all. It isn't. Worldly success in and of itself is not a good or an evil. It's what we do with it that is good or evil. And so that's, and I hope that's of some benefit to all of you. Once again, I think I'd urge you to read the passage on your own, because you'll find more of an engagement with it. The 57th surah of the Quran, Surah Al-Hadid, and this is the first passage. Thank you so very much for listening. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.